Hello everyone, here is a presentation from 2nd International Conference on the Digital Age, and first 3 minutes of the presentation is not recorded, and I'm really sorry about that. So I will show you the most important slides which are missing. My name is Milan Nikolic. First, here is the references of this work. Introduction and most important slide, schematic view of this work, where the aim of the work is defined and give topology of the work, where present two parts of the work and their subparts. And this slide is missing too. So let's go and enjoy.
We can notice three types of information: when site overwhelming architecture characteristics, when building overpower overwhelming, and first most favorable solution when building and site is merging. So, parametric structures is unusual and extraordinary forms, and most often create a new identity of the site. So, it generates additional responsibility for architectural design, and is more suitable to public spaces, stadiums, museums, and for example, airports. Further aspects, standard designs and anthropological dimensions is necessary aid to architectural planning, and can this help can improve quality of the proposal or prevent some errors. So parametric design require that all parts of design should be correlated. So, avoiding straight lines, stem lines, straight and broken angles, and all transitions through design should be gradual. Addition or subtraction element should be performed in interaction with other processes. And fourth aspect is relation of form and function. This is more objective observation. This is there is five types of relation, and only fifth type is acceptable type. From 1 to 4 is can damage form or can damage function, and is not so good solution. So function and form should be treated in joint action in parallel solving problems, you know. And parametric in the very beginning of the stage of the parametric design is to determine the interdependence between element and whole system and create hierarchy with the lower and higher levels of design. When we create systems of correlations, we can, by simple articulating and manipulating the parameter, can create many different solutions, and in that way provide quality of the final solution. Second part of the work. There is classification, which are dependent on the influence of parametric design which have on architectonic surface. First type is flat surface, where we can implement parametric design in flat surface. This is don't have to be dependent great extent of design and to methodological planning, as you say. It's not recommended to use on the whole form, because they can provide some visually noisy effects. It's recommended to use partial interpolation. So, second type, lateral surface. That surface are not directly connected to all surfaces of this object, and they change perception of the space as you leave the space. You know, create some functional zones which are unique to this lateral surface, and give more aesthetic and visual function. Third type is covers. Covers connect with all surfaces of the building, and with this type of surface, accurate distinction between floor heights is lost, and very easy to create some fluid interaction between functional zone and space in floor. Classification is based by sub-element form variation. It's, as you know, a lower level. power variation is implemented in order to avoid monotony and not recommended to use with algorithm effects. Second type is form sub-element variation, where we can vary some sub-element variation in different forms by any function or picture or grayscale value or something. And this influences the perception of face to throwing of standard transparent surface and creating some game like jail. And third type is transform sub-element variation, include movement, rotation or scaling, and this can create some kinetic or dynamic systems. And here is some discussion of the result, and as I said before, probability of choosing the most variable solution is enhanced by multiplication of the possible solutions and their variations. So, biggest problem with the conventional understanding of architectural practice is to overview the whole process simultaneously. And in that way, architects use some immutable starting model, and in that way, constrain the design process, constrain the creativity, use some intuitive thinking, anticipation, and that really damages the creative process of design and planning. So, on the other hand, parametric complex structures are the product of innovative thinking and a freer experience space. And as Andrea said before, with, in conjunction with appropriate software solution, we can use the full potential of this design method. And in the end, conclusion, the perception of space evolved with the new sophisticated needs, and multidimensional analysis is not multiple only static coordinates in space, and reflected to all dynamic, multimedia, multi-interactive process with more sensibility, and all design problems are now reflected to the architecture planning. So, by simple variation of partial requirements, we can architect the whole system, and that's the point. The change, this change include change of thinking and establishing the needs and their relation, and the purpose of digital technology is not to make final decision, but to shorten the time in certain phases. So, the crucial thing which changed during the planning methodology and parametric design is to think like a programmer and make decisions like an architect. You know, if you limit at the edge of the program, you may want to bend on the create new rule, and in that way you may have to create some new profile of programmer, architect programmer, and that should be the direction for the next research. Thank you for listening.
Just from a single idea of the architect. So the architect has that moment of wow, it perceives an idea and everything is going from a top-down level. So from that idea, he has to solve the idea in order to realize it. From the programmer, we are starting to think about architecture as a bottom-up process. So we are grounding the possible relationship between all the things that compose the architecture. And we are also trying to establish a set of relations between these kind of things. And the system started to operate.
First establish the need, and then establish the relation.
There are a huge amount of things that you can decide to code or not. And this is something very architectural. You have to decide what you want to put inside your algorithm or not. This is a very architectural decision. And then you start to let the system in some way operate and check for possible different solutions. So it's not a wow moment architecture, but something that is really more coded, because you have to choose which are the data that you want to put inside your architecture, which are the relationship between all the elements. And then you can choose between many, many different solutions.
So
like a programmer.
So it's not like the final decision, it's the architect decision, it's the more operative.
Yes. This also is a more sensitive decision. Program work on given instruction, just. And architect have to, yes, transition.
Anybody say, it's set by architect.
Right. Sometimes I would say the opposite.
architect is not the best in programming, and program is not the best in architect. And because of that, we have created some new profiles.
In the last year, I start to think that the next architect will be not architect at all, because the best things are coming from different fields than architecture, that are going faster and faster according to the technological evolution. Anyway, architect have to cope with that or not. So probably, in order to survive as a species, if we want to
Species,
we have to adapt really rapidly to all the changes that are occurring.
And this helps to adapt more easier, as you said.
Yes. And it's interesting, and we will speak about everything, and during the break and afterward. So thank you, and now I will...